Ladies and gentlemen, here's my mommy and daddy from FM Smith.
Guess I'm just old-fashioned. I guess I'm just a prude. I don't like risque parties or skiing in the nude. When I go out to dinner in some secluded place, don't want a topless waitress waving hors d'oeuvres in my face. No bolero or mirror tiles, no reef knots to untie, no flips, no whips, no fights, no lights. I'm a little bit shy. Too boring, don't misunderstand. I like making music, but not with a 10-piece band. I don't discuss my love life, reveal it or describe it. It's not that I think it's dirty, it's just that I think it's private.
A bedroom's fine for a girl and guy, but it's no place for the camera's eye. Focus, focus, please don't focus. I'm a little bit shy.
Thank you.
All right, kids, this is an experiment to give us more information about the central nervous system. You have each been fitted with sensing devices, and when either of you becomes physically aroused, it will trigger the signaling device like this. This one for you, Mary Ellen. And this one for you, Frankie. Good luck. We'll be watching.
Hi.
Hi.
This is kind of uncomfortable, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is. I didn't know I'd have to take all my clothes off.
Well, you don't have to be shy. You're very pretty.
Thank you.
You find me attractive?
No.
Boy, didn't take you very long to hurt my feelings.
I'm sorry, it's just that I've always been used as a sex object.
Okay, kids, we'd like you to lift the blanket now and just look at each other.
Oh, okay.
No, I don't want to.
Yes, you do. Oh, geez. A lot of wires and things on you, eh? Transistors and stuff?
Yeah. What's that?
Relax, it's just an aerial.
Listen, kids, this isn't working. We're going to break for the day and try again tomorrow. Thank you.
Oh, brother.
Sorry.
Well,
it was nice meeting you.
Oh, it was nice meeting you.
I could have a kiss goodbye.
Well, I guess it wouldn't hurt. Hey.
Listen, would you like to go out with me tonight?
Okay, sounds like fun. Not that much fun.
I got one problem.
What's that?
My cousin's in town. He's gonna need a date. You got a sister or a girlfriend or anything?
No, I've just got one brother.
Heaven's
to Betsy, look what they've done. Now it's a game, it used to be fun. Miss Q, take two, oh my, goodbye, I'm a little bit shy.
Get out of bed, you two.
Thank you, and please welcome our guest, Mr. Peter Donato.
It's all razzmatazz, little virtue in their way, just the same old jazz, getting them through their day, finding something that eased the pain. Music's too loud to explain. Too much work, too little satisfaction causes this type of reaction. Great wife, easy life, something more he desires. Free spirit that he is, he keeps looking for brighter fires, finding something to stop the boy. Not realizing he's bored with himself. If he keeps it up, you know we'll find him just an unused toy on the shelf. Well, I leave, so he said and he did, and now he's back again. Break away, start fresh, but he found it was much too much of a strain. So he's back in the same old razzmatazz again. Back in the same old razzmatazz again. Oh, the bright lights must put stars in his eyes, and he's seen his dream come in more than one disguise. He's been following false leads, running into dead ends, courting success like a jealous lover, mistaking vultures for friends. When the compliments fly free and fast, and words on the way they are thrown, and you're thinking there's more to life than this, and you don't have time alone, you're back in that same old razzmatazz again. Back in the same old razzmatazz again. It's all razzmatazz, a little virtue in their ways, just the same old jazz, getting them through their days. It's all razzmatazz, it's all razzmatazz, it's all razzmatazz, it's all razzmatazz.
I've been asked to come on the show and say a few words. Well, I'm perfectly normal. What makes you think I'm not? Unless it's filth you want. Is that what you want? Dirty language and smut? Filthy pictures and obscene indecencies? Well, count me out. I like good, clean fun, sure. I'll go to a party and play biblical Scrabble. But when they strip down to the work socks and whip out the Super 8, well, it's time for old Stephanie to go home. Because, friends, I cannot tolerate dirt of any kind. That's just the cut of my jib. I'm the cleanest person I know. I vacuum my hair. And I keep my house clean, too. How many of you Simonize your driveway? And my fridge, you know what I've got in it? 400 pounds of baking soda. No food. Yuck! And I'm proud to say I do not own a trash can. If, due to unforeseen circumstance, I get some garbage in my home, I put it in the microwave for 78 hours, and then we move. I detest any kind of impurity. Do you know how many germs are in a pizza? Take a close look sometime. Those pepperonis are moving, I swear it, they're moving. And do you think I want those cooties crawling around inside me? Not really. And neither does my husband, Henry. He's as clean as I am. When he comes home from work, I rip off his clothes and boil them while he sits out in the front porch in the sheep dip. And you should see his dresser. Everything washed and bleached, washed and bleached. Socks, underwear, sweaters, washed and bleached. And neat as a pin. Mother always said, you don't know a man till you see what's in his drawers. And of course, we don't have any children. You know what that involves. Not too disgusting. But then it's just as well. Children probably wouldn't hose themselves down with ammonia like we do. Oh, sure, you might say I'm obsessed, deranged, bent, perverted, crazy, possibly insane. So what? I'm clean cut. I don't do anything dirty. I haven't been to the bathroom since 1962. My brother says that's why I'm full of it. But what does he know? He's a dirty, filth... Oh, I'm afraid you'll have to excuse me.
Henry, where's the bathroom?
I gotta tell you, my sister is nothing like that. Maury again, our musical director, Paul Benton, both kind of like music from the 30s and 40s and stuff, and they gotten together and done a song called The Man That Got Away, and it turned out real nice. Here it is.
The night is bitter, the stars have lost their glitter, the wind grows colder, and suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. No more his eager call. The man that won you has run off and undone you. That great beginning has seen the final inning. Don't know what happened, it's all a crazy every trick of his, you're on to. But fools will be fools, and where's he gone to? The road gets rougher, it's lonelier and tougher, with hope you burn up. Tomorrow he may turn up. There's just no let up. The live long. Ever since this world began,
Hi. We're at the Comedy Club this week to see Maurice LaMarche.
I was reading an article in Us Magazine the other week about famous stars and the kind of odd jobs they took before they hit it big. And the one they all worked at was a waiter. Like, can you see Johnny Carson working as a waiter? good evening and welcome to Chateau Maine. Well, the specialty of the house is smoked salmonella. No, I'm kidding. Actually, if I were you, I wouldn't eat the food here. You see, the chef just got fired from the NBC commissary. So the food here is, well, it's kind of bad. Thank you very much for asking. The food here is so bad. Now, get this. Food here is so bad, the funeral expenses are included in your bill. How about my favorite TV... Thank you. How about my favorite TV detective, Peter Falk? Working as a waiter, but in the poshest place in town, the five-star restaurant. See him getting fired after only about a week, and this is the kind of incident that would lose him his job.
Hey. Excuse me, ma'am. I don't want to bother you or anything, but is there a problem here with your husband? He's lying kind of still with a knife sticking out of his back. I thought maybe there was something wrong. You're kidding. You mean to say that one of our busboys came up with a steak knife and stabbed your husband in the back? Geez, I think I can explain the confusion. Do you remember when your husband asked me for that knife? I went over to the busboy and I said, "You see this steak knife? Give it to that man in the back." I think there was some confusion.
A lot of politicians getting in the restaurant business, too. For instance, one day, Pierre Trudeau will retire from politics, and when he does, he's going to open up a little bistro in downtown Ottawa.
Good evening, and welcome to Shea Legislature, where you don't order what you want, you vote for it. We don't have much lamb in the meat locker, but we do have a liberal supply of bull. We also have the Joe Who Conservative Special, whole wheat bread and water. And, of course, the NDP plate, a chicken dish consisting of left wings and rear ends.
Thank you very much, guys.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you. When I am with you, getting to know what to say. Nothing. Getting to hear you, putting it to us en français. You are precise, mon bilingual.
May we?
Getting to try. Almost as far as I can throw you. Getting to mic you, getting it all down on tape. Haven't you noticed I'm making lots of extra money from selling all the scandalous and new things I'm learning about you.
Tonight, we all need oil too. I know how it feels to knock Clark off his heels as he speaks through his nose in a trance. He speaks through his nose on the chance that he knows, and he knows he blew his big chance. Be brave, Ed Broadbent, and follow your star. I hope your labors are few. Cling very close to the liberals tonight. I've got a good deal for you. We've all been frozen and
deception is very strange to say. For when you fool the people up north, La Mam shows on Gaspé.
I take a holiday, and every single time, the fact that I'm away convinces them that I'm really cool.
Make believe you're suave with a little touch of snob. You have much more class than John or Joe or Bob. Canadians love a man who doesn't want the job.
Shall we?
Won't.
Is there time for in my room?
Shall we vote?
Are the polls going to shock us if we do? Or perchance, when the final results have all come in, will I still be a sinister perennial prime minister, king of the downhill slope? On the clear premonition that there's just no competition, shall we vote? Shall we vote? Shall we vote?
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And help us thank Peter Donato and Maurice LaMarche. Shall we vote?
Bad luck, heartache, losing but too tired to fight. But if you take care of someone who loves you, then everything will turn out right. If you take care of someone who loves you, then everything will turn out right.
Good night, everybody.